The man you're married to now, we should point out, is obviously not the man who abused you back then. It was just 5 days, I understand, before your first wedding that the abuse began.
Yes, that's exactly right. And there had been no hint of violence before that. I think it's one of the things that's so complicated about domestic violence that people don't understand is that for so long, the love is so good. And it's what makes it feel so crazy when the violence starts. So my husband attacked me early in the morning. He choked me. And I really thought he would never do it again. I promise you, that's what I thought. And I married him. The bruises on my neck had just faded. And then he beat me twice more on our honeymoon. And for the rest of our marriage, he proceeded to attack me, you know, every few days, every few weeks. And it was something that nothing in my life could have prepared me for. And also, believe it or not, it wasn't until after the relationship ended that I realized that I was a battered woman.
Well, you know, we just had a guest, Carol Costello, on in the last hour, who said the exact same thing happened to her, not to that extent, but that it was years before she realized, wait, what happened to me was a crime.
It's so common. I didn't know that it was a crime. I thought I was a strong, smart woman in love with a troubled, wonderful man who I wanted to help. And it's part of why it's just so crazy, is that from the outside, this sounds like insanity. Even to me now, it sounds like insanity. But back when I was with him, I felt so sorry for him. He'd had an abusive childhood himself. He was smart and funny, and he adored me. And I thought if I could just help him get through this small problem, that we would live happily ever after. And it really took years for my denial to break down, but I realized that it was a choice between him or me. And the only reason I'm here today is that in some very dark moments, I chose me.
Is it ever just once?
Only if you leave after the first time. And there are lots of women, and men too, you know, because I have to say that men can be victims of domestic violence too. There are people who see the writing on the wall, if you will, and are able to leave. I wasn't one of those people. I had so much denial, and also my ex-husband was really, he was just such a sympathetic character in some ways. He was really, truly charming, and I had never felt so deeply understood by any human being in my life. Mm-hmm. And I just wanted, it was like a drug. I wanted to get back to those early days before the violence had started.
You know, many times people ask that question of, well, why didn't the woman leave? Why did she end up marrying him? Why? Which in many ways almost sounds like blaming the victim. But I guess my question is, what made you finally leave?
Because there was one particular beating that was just so brutal. I was unconscious for most of it, and I became convinced that he was going to kill me. And I somehow was able to leave. Something changed in me during that time. But what you say is really, really important, because it is a way of blaming the victims. You know, I was stuck in a psychological trap disguised as love. Even though I'm smart and I went to Harvard and I am confident in lots of ways, I was vulnerable to it. Anybody can be vulnerable to it.
And he had isolated you. I mean, he had taken you out of New York City. You were in a town. You didn't know other people. He'd isolated you. He had determined who your friends and family were, you know, who you got to see, who you spent Christmas with. What is your message to other women out there who may be going through this right now?
I think that you need to learn everything you can about relationship violence before it ever happens to you. And I think the simplest thing to look for is, don't confuse pity and love. If you're dating somebody and they expect you to feel sorry for them, then that is a huge red flag. And that is what I see in Janae Palmer. She feels sorry for Ray Rice, and she feels that she needs to protect him. And I think that women have to really watch out for this. And again, men have to watch out for it too, because we talk all the time about women, and women are the vast majority of domestic violence victims. But this is not about physical control of somebody. It's about emotional and mental coercion, which doesn't always have to include physical dominance. Mm.
Great advice for people. Crazy Love is the book. Leslie Morgan Steiner, thank you so much.